a 360-degree panoramic dome microwave. And air-in shower technology uses 35% less water by putting tiny air bubbles inside each droplet of water. Vsauce, Kevin here. This is Mind Blow. Ghent University in Belgium has developed a contact lens that displays text. The transparent lens can modulate the transmitted light using LCD technology, and the image is visible to other people, not the wearer. But they are currently researching ways to display text to the person wearing the lens, and hope to create a way for road directions, text messages, and emails to be on your eyes within 5 years. DARPA is developing a foam to help wounded soldiers mitigate damage from internal hemorrhaging. The wound stasis technology is designed to be administered on the battlefield and works with two liquid phases injected internally that mix to become foam, which molds around the organs, compressing internal wounds until the patient can be safely transported to a surgeon, who then easily removes the foam and treats the injury. Kenshiro is a humanoid robot that copies your muscles and bones. It's the closest to a human form so far and mimics the body of the average Japanese 12-year-old male with the same weight ratios. It has 160 pulley-like muscles, does squats, and features aluminum bones. Newly discovered loris, check. Brand new species, check. Extremely cute, check. Venomous teeth, check. Gravity light is an alternative to kerosene lamps that harnesses the power of gravity. The LED lanterns cost less than $10 to buy, with no running costs, and the 3 seconds it takes to lift the weight, made up of a bag filled with rocks or dirt, powers the light for half an hour. It has no batteries, is specifically for countries without reliable access to mains electricity, and you can find out more over at their website. University of Bath researchers are claiming that vector-based video will lead to the death of the pixel within the next 5 years. Digital pictures are made up of a rectangular grid of colored cells or pixels. The smaller and closer together, the higher the quality and amount of data that needs to be compressed. But vectors present contoured colors with the highest visual quality without a bunch of pixels needing to be compressed. And they say this will revolutionize the way visual media is produced.
Yo, you got sneaker speakers? Yeah, alright.
Neuroscientists and software engineers at the University of Waterloo in Canada have built the most complex artificial brain ever. SPAUN isn't just a supercomputer, it mimics the structure of a real brain, and has 2.5 million simulated neurons constructed to pattern the brain's cranial subsystems. It also has a digital eye for visual input, a robot arm to draw responses, and can pass very basic IQ tests. Finally, further up yonder is a time-lapse from the International Space Station, put together by Giacomo Sardelli.
As the most forward deployed citizens of the planet at this moment, we, the first expedition crew aboard Space Station Alpha, we are well started on our journey of exploration and discovery, building a foothold for men and women who will voyage and live in places far away from our home planet. We are opening the gateway to space for all humankind.
I'm going to leave you with a radar sequence of an asteroid that's over 4 million miles away from Earth. And as always, thanks for watching.